and people tell me I haven't seen Sholay, and I'm like, oh my god, you haven't seen Sholay? But at the same time, like, okay, it's not that great, it's fine, it's okay, no big deal.
Sometimes the universe is a little too difficult on us. You feel you won't make it and that there is no hope left at all. But one must keep rolling, because life becomes a little easier when you have someone to share the load with. And when you least expect it, the rains will go away and it will all be sunny, like a story of the summer. Welcome to Alive and Kicking with Rahul Bamne. New episodes every Friday.
I really want to know how Mumbai Meri Jaan happened. Mumbai Meri Jaan happened, then there was a song Bombay Meri Jaan behind it, and I'll get to that later, but the song is a beautiful song behind it, and then it was picked up by Things to Do in Bombay.
Things to Do in Mumbai, it's an Instagram page
which has a lot of followers. Again, guys, she's famous. but it was picked up by an Instagram page, and it just kept getting reposted again and again and again and again, to a point where it has 90,000 plus views. How do you feel? And tell me, how did this video happen? Like, this is ye khulasa hone wala. This is that khulasa on Alive and Kicking with how Mumbai Meri Jaan happened.
Okay, so I was just trying my hands at Premiere Pro. I've never used that, and I was learning all about it, and I decided that if I love Mumbai so much, let's just make a video on it. And this was way before quarantine started, way before the lockdown started, that I sat and thought of a concept regarding Mumbai and what video should I put in and everything. It was a very small, basic concept. And then later during quarantine, I think I personally missed everything, every single thing mentioned in that video. So I just put my heart out to it, and I thought, why not give it a black and white retro feel, because it's like in the past. It's been so long that we've been doing things like that, and I put my little obsession for retro in it, the feel in the video. And yeah, that is how I came up with the whole concept of Mumbai Meri Jaan. And I thought maybe, you know, people will relate to it and they would like something like this. This is something they want to see. So yeah, that is how it happened. And I was so glad, I was so happy when people came and like they messaged me, told me that this is something they wanted to see. Thank you so much. This made their day. Oh my God. I think you'll relate to the feeling where people are like, thank you so much. This is so good. And it just feels amazing. So
it happens. Few times when I put up a poetry or something and I get a reply saying, you know, this one was so good, man. It touched my, and it just makes you feel good, like, I'm here, you're somewhere else.
Else,
I don't know where you are.
I could
really, you know, touch,
reach out to you.
I'm going to go and take you through a couple of these eras, okay? Like,
okay.
So what I did was, you know, I started this back in 1957, and actually 55, let's just say, and then I took a 10 year evolution just to understand what you think how movies have transitioned over the years. So so we go with 1957. Mother India. I think the word itself is enough. I mean, Oscar nomination and the story,
wonderful acting by all of it.
All of them, you know, and the story, obviously. And I don't know if you remember this song called Leke Pehla Pehla Pyar.
Yes, I do.
From this movie called CID, Devanand, Vahida Rehman.
Again, Vahida Rehman.
Yeah, again. And 56, 57, I'm not sure. But this was the time. Okay, these two movies, and to what Mother India was, okay, to what fame it rose, is so. And I think it's nobody anticipated that kind
in the
of,
movie,
you know, response.
Even the acting by Nargis, like, she's never done, I don't think I've seen her in her previous movies, like, she's never portrayed such a role before. It was
she was so vulnerable. Vulnerable.
And so powerful at the same time.
Same time, you know, and just the whole entire scenario of how she's raising her children, she's
children,
doing everything
yeah.
she could. And I thought this was, if we could think of something like this in 1957, you know, I mean, that's amazing. Exactly. Like, it was so way ahead of its time.
That movie was way ahead of its time. Portraying such a strong female character.
And I think we still refer to it, the fact that years later, people still go back talking about Mother India.
Yeah. The whole point was that Sunil Dutt and Dilip Kumar or Rajendra Kumar. And they were not the center of the movie, but
she was. Can you believe
it? I know.
It was so funny. I'll tell you, because here we are in 2020, people talking about women-centric movies, and I was like, I'm sorry. We had the most women-centric movie in 1957. Mother India was the most women-centric movie, and they had no problem with it.
Exactly. You know? It was like you didn't even have to ask for it. It was a fact. It was a fact proven back then. You know, like,
yeah, exactly.
Women are capable of something like this.
I think it's
like
fair
this.
To say that we've actually gone backwards in time.
Yeah.
Because if we could do something as great as Mother India in 57, I think we should have, as an industry, as an audience, grown
better. From it. Yeah.
But we go through 1957 Mother India to 1965, and the eternal Vakt. I mean, I remember watching this in quarantine. Okay.
I think this was this was the time where there were a lot of family-centric movies.
Yeah,
it's such a joint family concept. Yeah.
You know? And I remember, again, this came in the house, and we parents were like, you know, you should watch this movie called Vak. The acting is amazing, such a big cast. It's like Kalank, as big as Kalank, six actors, you know, big actors.
Yeah.
But a better story.
Way better, please. When you said Kalank, I was like, no,
but Vak was so, I think it was long, but it was not boring, yaar. I mean, I remember just being hooked on to it every second. Sharmila, Shashi.
Yeah.
Shashi. Sunil Dutt. And I think Sadhana, if I'm not wrong. I don't know.
Yeah, there was Sadhana and...
And then there was the Raj Kapoor.
No. I think it was Rajendra Kumar, I feel.
No, yeah, it was not this guy.
The main guy, the bad guy.
Yeah,
bad,
who's
but not
the elder
the bad.
Brother?
Yeah.
Who's the elder brother? Elder brother was Raj. Huh. Elder brother was Raj, younger brother was, sabse young was Shashi, and the middle wala brother was Sunil. Remember?
I'm still not clear on the eldest brother.
But yeah, and it was funny, you know, because I thought agar three heroes honge to three heroines honge, but
yeah.
It was three heroes and two heroines, like the elder one, it's
Raj Kumar.
We got Raja. Balraj Sahni was their father, Shashi, Sharmila, you know. So yeah, I mean,
but
then
I think
what
they could have done much better with the ending. I still have that
ending.
You know,
the
yeah.
whole court scene.
Yeah, that was too
yeah.
swift and so quick, you know. The fact that he just came and he said,
I think they tried to wrap it.
Yeah, they just wrapped it up very quickly. But otherwise, no complaints.
No complaints. I love that movie. Love it. Exactly. And then we move on to 1975. I'm not going to take the name that everybody expects me to take. But I'm going to say they were beautiful movies like Diwar. There was Julie.
Yes.
Julie and the songs from Julie, man. The
movie is really nice. You know, I recently saw the movie and I used to hear about it a lot from my mom and all. And I actually saw it. And, you know, it's a really nice movie. But my heart aches for her. Like, what she had to go through. And it was really sad. And,
yeah.
You know, people now also would relate to it somewhat. Like, women would relate to it. Now too,
yeah. And there was something like Chupke Chupke, Dharmendra, Sharmila.
Oh, I enjoyed that movie.
Hai na?
Yeah.
But out of all of this, and I think there were way more movies, you know, 1975,
76. I think 70s was a very diverse year in
Very diverse year.
Content.
Very diverse.
This is when we had parallel cinema and all of that also, like, you know, starting off.
But at this, you know, while these movies were going on, there was so much importance to Sholay.
Yeah.
I mean, it was 75 again, the year 75. The story, and I love it, okay? I've watched it, I think I've watched it twice probably, or thrice maximum. And I think it's a great story. It's based in a village, two friends, songs are good, you know, actresses are good, etc.
It's very extravagant and everything.
Hai na? But at the same time, I felt that it was
over. I know. Like, you know, when people tell me I haven't seen Sholay, and I'm like, oh my god, you haven't seen Sholay? But at the same time, like, okay, it's not that great. It's fine. It's okay.
Yeah, I mean, today we'll go the same, like, have you not seen Game of Thrones? You've not seen Game of Thrones.
But then after the last season, we'll go like, oh, it's okay. It's fine. It's okay, just watch.
But that's the thing, you know, about Sholay, because that's why it took other names before I went to Sholay. I said, there were movies as good as Deewar, and which had crazy dialogues.
I think it was just because the cast was so different and had a huge cast with a lot of good hit songs, probably. That is why it got hit. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, that's why it took
and
the whole
box friendship
office.
Angle and cute love stories.
Yeah, exactly, right? But I think it's good, it's fair.
The only person I feel bad for in that movie is Jaya Bachchan.
Jaya Bachchan.
Throughout. Even in the end, like, come on. Should have given her a little Amitabh Bachchan, no.
A little Amitabh Bachchan.
Like, at least she should have gotten Amitabh Bachchan.
Yeah, I mean, through the entire movie, I get it. But let's move ahead. We go to 1985. And it has to be Sagar for me, okay? Sagar, Rishi Kapoor, Kamal Hassan, Dimple Kapadia. What a change in movies and the way they were perceived, you know? Like, a trio. Firstly, a trio who are amazing. I mean, I love the songs from Sagar. And the fun they had in the movie, the dances and everything, it was great. And this was Dimple Kapadia. I think, I don't know when Bobby came, but this was such a change from what
Bobby,
Dimple and Rishi Kapoor were in Bobby to what they were in Sagar, you know. And we got to see Kamal Hassan in that, and he has to be one of my favorites.
Chachi 420.
Oh my god, I was just going to say Chachi 420. How can we not? I've grown up watching that movie every damn time. If I see a kutta and I'm like, aapka kutta kaatta hai. This is how impactful that movie is on me.
And it's crazy, you know. I think so. We can actually see a sort of huge jump of story writing, of acting, obviously development in color cinema from black and white and stuff from 1955 to 85, 40 years, I mean, four decades. Do you think we were writing better stories back then? Like,
absolutely, the stories were way better back then. Maybe the execution, you can say that, of course, with technology and everything, would be better right now. But I think if you talk about stories, they were better back then. The ideas that people came up with, it was more relatable than what movies are right now.
And I think at the same time, there was really a lot of focus on content. You know how we have again come to this era now, everybody's like saying content is king, and we had Beach Ke, we had like 20
glamour,
years.
Yeah.
Where it
which
was nothing
on
but
only
like,
glamour.
You know, yeah, it was probably content which was not great at all. But then I think 50s, 60s, 70s was time when they really, really focused on the stories. They didn't care how the actors looked, if they didn't have a vanity van, if they didn't, get good costumes. And I mean, you must have heard so many stories about how they were doing these stunts. You know, Amitabh Bachchan, for
everyone,
he
was injured for it too.
The
dedication was
like they really did
it. Yeah, it felt like they put more heart to it in their work back then. I don't know if I'm saying it the right way, but it felt more like people put their heart in movies and they actually wanted to come up with something very beautiful, something very relatable and fun to watch. At the same time, focuses on reality that is happening right now.
And not that we mean to say that people are not putting their heart right now. Obviously they must be, but it just felt, I think it was not easy back then. you didn't have stunt doubles, you didn't have a big budget, you had to do 2-3 shifts at a time.
So you're
shooting, for example, you're shooting with Trishul in the morning, then
Sagar. Some other movie. Exactly.
And they still made it, right? You know, they still made it somehow. And all the movies worked well.
Very well, yeah.
So I think it's fair to say stories really had a lot of weightage back then.
Yeah.
We go to 1995, and I want to discuss two parallel sort of things with you. Is we have something like a DDLJ. Okay, I like it. Again the same thing as Shole. Okay.
I like it.
I don't know why it's still running in Maratha Mandir. I mean, it's good that people still love it, but yeah, it's a great watch. So DDLJ, you have a DDLJ going here. You have a Karan Arjun going here in 1995.
I think it's fair to say Shah Rukh Khan dominated that era.
That sort of an era, you know. And at the same time, you have someone like a Govinda doing Kooli number one. BV number one.
Hero number one. Auntie number one.
And it was hilarious. It was, I think,
you
it's
know, back then
say,
it was so hilarious when you used to watch Govinda movies. And now when I go back and I watch those movies, I'm like, oh my god, I found this funny. I still do at some point, but then I start questioning why did I find this funny?
You know, and I think it was a lot of physical comedy.
Yeah.
You know, with him moving, with him acting, with him owning the entire
camera
space.
Yeah.
Sort of, you know. And not that the women of the movie were not. I mean, they were amazing. Beat Sushmita Sen, Karishma.
Raveena Tandon, all of them.
All of them. The songs they did, the dance.
Iconic.
iconic pop song sort of a thing. And it was sort of like a rom-com of Indian cinema.
This worked so well for Govinda. Like, I saw him in this movie called Ghar or something, where he was
very serious,
who was very obedient and all of that. And then I see the Govinda and Auntie number one and BV number one. And I'm like, okay. Worked for him well.
Yeah, works. This
suited.
Works for you better.
Yeah.
I'm going to move ahead and ask you in this segment, what do you think, Christine, how are men and women portrayed? So let's go with everything, okay? Let's go with men being portrayed today, the way they're portrayed today and the way they were portrayed in movies like Mard by Amitabh Bachchan, back then, the whole idea of masculinity. So what do you think, how are men portrayed today?
Today, I feel men are more on the, like, they've given a more emotional touch to men. Like, men are now free to express what they feel, how they feel. It's okay to cry on screen. That is the most important evolution that has happened in Indian cinema. If you see back then, I don't remember men crying except for being in love or something apart from that.
Yeah, or probably they were crying when they were with their mother or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, they wouldn't cry in public in front of everyone.
And now it's more about that, and you know, it's more about supporting women also in any way they can. Like, men are not the center of attraction, only center of attraction right now.
Yeah.
It's like they've been given supporting roles, they've given small role, you know, someone who can just give a little push to the protagonist. So men are fine doing roles like that now.
And I'll have to bring this to your notice. You know, I remember this scene from Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara when Farhan Akhtar is standing in front of Nasiruddin Shah and he cries, you know.
Yeah.
And that particular scene when they depict the relationship between the strangled relationship between a father and his son. And this has never happened before, you know, either in the old movies, either you're against him, you're fighting against your own father or something. But here is where you're confronting them and you're okay. You're crying.
I think it's okay to be vulnerable on screen now.
Yeah, for men, especially for men, you know.
Yeah.
And I love the fact like a Rajkumar doing a supporting role in Queen, you know. You know, it's so unreal, right? They will never hire a A-lister, or, you know, I'm not saying he's not an A-lister, he is obviously,
anybody,
but the big Khans and everything, they will never be in a supporting cast. you know, because it's a exactly. women-centric movie mm-hmm. again.
But Shah Rukh Khan went on and he did Dear Zindagi.
Beautiful.
Which I love him. After a huge like list of movies, he's done yeah. one good movie recently, Dear Zindagi, where he was this guy who gave a push to the protagonist to help her around, not just, you know, take over her completely
yeah,
and be the center
of
attraction.
I like a very few selected movies by SRK. I like Dawn. Even though it's a remake, mm. I like Dawn. I like... Veer Zara.
Same, yeah.
I love, you know, the entire, as dramatic as I sound, as pathetic as it sounds, I love Kabhi Khushi Kabhi Gham, Kal Ho Na Ho.
Oh my God.
Kabhi Alvida Na
Kal Ho Na Ho.
You know,
Na
so,
Kehna, same.
But
same.
There are movies which I don't like, you know, which I think he should not have chosen to do, or, you know, they didn't work that
chosen.
Well, you know. But, mm. but here are, and the Dear Zindagi comes into that category. Mental health,
yeah.
Alia Bhatt at the center, he being a counselor, and he really is. And you can finally see men taking the role of their age. Thank God.
Age, exactly.
You know, when they expect a tabu
acting
to
like
take roles of her age.
Of her
know,
mother.
And she is
and, yeah.
the goddess. Tabu, tabu. I'm going to do this tabu. Because I love her. It's amazing. It's the way. And I'm so waiting for the suitable boy. You know, she's amazing.
Yeah.
I loved her in Heather.
I've seen the trailer. Oh my
blowing
God, she was mind
Hena.
Blowing in Heather. There was this movie with Katrina Kaif and Aditya Roy Kapoor.
Fitur.
That movie didn't do great,
but I
haven't
Tabu seen it.
In that movie. Oh my God,
yeah?
You have to watch it just for Tabu, not
just
for
Tabu.
Yes. You have to watch her in that movie. It's
and stunning. I love, you know, I love Namesake by her. I love Makbool.
Makbool.
Chini Kam. Drishyam.
Yeah. She's
the
taken a diverse role and challenging roles.
You know,
Tabu.
and she's doing well. I think she's
yeah.
really like there. You know?
She's one of those
so,
actresses who are doing amazing right now.
Amazing, amazing.
Yeah.
Even when... A lot of other actresses have stopped working. Tabu still goes on to do, you know, groundbreaking roles
yeah.
for that. And that's where I bring you to the portrayal of women. You know, the way women were portrayed before, and the way they are. And I'll tell you, I can totally sense that the way movies are portraying people, it has a huge impact on our lives.
Yes, it does.
Like
as Indians, we are obsessed with movies.
Yeah, we are obsessed, you know, like Vidya Balan says in Shakuntala Devi, she says, we Indians like drama, it's drama or nothing.
Yeah.
You know, because I see the way women get treated in their households, the way they get treated on the streets, in public, on news channels, anywhere for that matter of fact, you know, where you have someone like today, someone like Kangana doing Queen, and really the journey of being a introvert woman who's afraid and being independent and, you know, saying
yeah.
a no to the man.
Yeah. That to going at his, like going in his house and saying a straight up no.
No. And to going on her honeymoon alone.
I love Queen for that reason. That is
I love
the
it.
One
I
love, movie
yeah.
which shows independence so beautifully.
So beautifully. So and the fact that it was a low budget movie, Vikas
yeah.
Behl made it. They didn't have a lot of time and it changed her entire image.
Yeah. Starting from gangster to something
to
like queen.
Queen. And I love where she's now, you know.
Yeah.
Even though, however things are turned out in personal life, but the career that she's
yeah.
had, Manikarnika doing that, Panga. I don't know if you've seen Panga.
Yeah,
Panga
yeah.
is also beautiful. So I think she's really doing roles which put women in good light.
This is the one thing that I like, the evolution of portrayal of women. Previously, you know, I love old movies, but you know, when I used to watch them, it's like, why are women portrayed something like this? Maybe it had to do something with how people were women were treated back then.
In reality.
Yeah, in reality, that was reflected in movies too. But it was just sad to see less screen,
yeah.
screen time, hardly any role. You know, There was hardly anything.
I think they were really there as objects. And I remember watching this one interview by Parveen Babi. No, Zina Taman. Sorry, Zina Taman saying how women were earlier used as objects or, you know, just to fill just in time.
Yeah. And with music and entertainment and glamour, that is all.
Yeah. And then she goes on to say that I want to do movies where I have a meaning. Like, I really... affect the story. I have a role, no matter how small it could be. It could be 10 minutes of a role, but my role really makes a difference. And this is the reason I love her in Dawn. I love her in other movies that she's done, where even though she's a supporting actress, you know, or even if she's there, just there, she's had an impact, you know. And same goes for
Parveen. She was one of the most glamorous women back then. Like, she dared to do something different than the other actresses. That's why she stood out.
Yeah, exactly. And I think women really are changing today. Neerja, for that matter of fact. A lot of real life stories.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for Gunjan Saxena, which is coming on Netflix.
I think Peepu is this very nice example.
Love it.
That movie is so, so realistic and relatable.
Yeah. And it really depicts what life is, you know, a daughter handling her father who has constipation issues and how beautifully they live together. She's giving up so much of her time, her life, and she chooses not to marry anyone, chooses not to be with anyone because she has someone like...
responsibilities,
you know,
yeah.
Yeah. So I think women are really... They're
even the role of Irfan Khan in that movie...
Supporting, again.
Not pushing, like not entirely filling up the screen, but you know, there.
Yeah, and so, for this reason we love Irfan Khan, right? Because he's been so amazing, and I hope wherever he's, you know, he's so good at heart. I think it's been a difficult year for all of us.
The whole Indian cinema. It's like a shock this
year.
It's
just this belief that, you know, I'm never going to see Irfan again. I can't...
Even off screen, he was this very highly intellectual guy. Like, I've seen interviews and amazing opinions, amazing thoughts.
Even the way he talks in his interviews.
Yeah.
For that, you know.
He looks like a very calm, positive person to talk to.
This takes me to the third space where I wanted to ask you, how do you think transgenders... and LGBT community has been portrayed in cinema, and are we responsible for what they go through? I have to bring this to your notice because I remember this in the middle sometime, the entire post about Bobby Darling
coming in late,
everywhere, you know, and people really feeling that they are responsible for how they portrayed Bobby in the movies.
Yeah, I remember watching Kya Super Cool Hai Hum. No, Kya Cool Hai Hum, the first part, I think she was in that movie, and all those movies where she was portrayed very like an object, I would say.
Yeah.
Just there for the comical element.
Yeah, I don't know, why do they think they're here for the funny? They're not a joke, I'm sorry. And they're not here to just fill in your humor.
Even back then, hijras were portrayed just, you know, as a funny element, a dance thing, you know, like blessings and all of that. And then there were movies where they were portrayed very, like, in a villain light, I would say.
Yeah.
Where there were murderers and secretly killing people and...
Yeah, they were portrayed in a bad light, you know. I remember some movies just saying they come and pick up your children and they take them away.
Yeah.
So this sense of fear in other so-called normal people.
I think media, like cinema, has a huge impact on us, on our thoughts also.
Totally.
So portraying something like that would definitely mean, you know, telling people like they know they are negative people, know they are not to be taken seriously and all of that. I think this is why we as audience blame ourselves for what we did to Bobby Darling back then.
Yeah, exactly. And you know, I don't know if you remember this one video which used to go viral all the time, where, you know, Nana Patekar is walking on the street
and
then he comes across a transgender.
Yeah,
and then she claps and she asks for money, and then he dances and then he claps and he says, "Ab main nacha, so you give me the money." And I remember laughing on it back then, but I've grown to unlearn it, to really realize the sensitivity of this issue.
But I still don't think we are taking them seriously in our cinema. Like, now Akshay Kumar is coming up with a movie, Lakshmi Bomb.
Yeah,
I think, okay, fine, a big actor portraying something like this is needed for Indian audiences, maybe because we're not used to seeing a transgender in a huge, taking a huge spot in cinema.
Yeah.
So maybe that's good for a start, but I hope they don't overtake it and actually go and introduce some actors, transgender actors,
yeah,
who portray that role.
Can you believe, I was just about to ask you that, don't you think instead of taking
Akshay Kumar, you could have just
taken a real transgender to portray the role. How difficult is it to find, you know, how difficult is it to cast someone for that role?
I remember there's this Lakshmi, if you know,
yeah.
I think, I don't know why, she they would have casted her because she's a known figure.
Personality, known
maybe.
Personality.
Yeah.
And you know, at the same time, I haven't seen Super Deluxe and I want to see it. But it's same. Again, a story of a straight cis man portraying a transgender in a movie. I love the cause. I love what you're trying to portray. But you could have actually taken a real person.
Hey, you can listen to the whole podcast on Spotify. Just click on the link in the bio.